Okay. I'm kind of glad the Border Princes didn't join in, because I would now have a fried computer.
It just explodes, you're like, damn it.
Damn you, Border Princes.
Damn you.
Damn you
all. Oy. Goodness, that was a massive battle.
That was pretty huge. I would have loved to have been able to see it at more than 10 frames per second.
I can probably take Stone Tower, because he doesn't have the main guys there.
Yeah.
Right. Cool, I think that might do it for my turn.
A productive one. By all means.
I can build a granary.
A granary? A granary.
Dwarves love that.
Yes, that's what I've heard. Dwarves love grand.
Nutrients and such.
Yes, they'd much rather bread than beer. And salted pork.
Whoa, where did this orc unit come from?
The what unit? The
green skin rebels. What the?
What? My rebels?
I think they're mine. I'm gonna have to deal with that later. That sucks. I think they revolted.
Oh, from Garbage Town.
Ugh. Yep, they still weren't happy with the name.
So they got in some orcs down. Okay. I'm still saving, really, for the goblin workshop thing. Do you want me to continue south with you?
It's up to you. I mean, you have to deal with those dwarves, right?
Shit.
We've got all of these. You're at war with all of this, right? All of this?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, once we defeat that will let us look at the dwarves next. I don't know. There's a lot of options on the table. A lot of options.
There is. I mean, I can't really go and take new territory yet, because I won't have any money to spend on improving the public relation. Because I'm saving for this flipping building, like I've been doing the entire game.
That's true.
So I may as well just help you out.
And always take them and then not tax them, and then that would probably let them be so rebellious.
I suppose. I've already gone south anyway. Not really much else to do.
Alright, so, well,
oh my god, they've got goblin spider raiders.
Doesn't matter, I've got Thorgrim.
I guess. They'll drop it on the spider.
Drop it. The chair. Well, I mean, I think this might be a good place to stop for this episode, since we had that huge ass battle. We can pick it up next episode, because then we're gonna have some more campaign movements going on to set up another battle, where another huge battle is gonna take place.
I thought we weren't doing that. I thought we were just gonna record one session, do an intro outro for the whole session.
Oh, okay. Then let's do that. I forget what I just said.
Yeah,
forget that.
If we take like a small break after a round, I think I've got it down as 54 minutes in game, and we probably talked for about 15. Mm-hmm. So if we play for about another 20-30 minutes, then that'll be two episodes. Do it like we did last time, two sessions, have a little break in the middle, and then you've got an intro and an outro between two episodes.
Okay, so you want to have a break or stop after the next, like, 30, 40 minutes?
Yeah.
Just take a little. All right, hey then. Alrighty, then we'll hop right back into it and forget everything I just said.
Nothing just happened. Look away.
nothing happened. Okay, so I gotta go over Crash's Rebellion with Thorgrim. That's gonna be great. God. I'm just gonna auto-resolve this, Jay. I'm gonna auto-resolve it.
Which one? Left one, yeah?
I don't remember what the button is. I hate rebellions in this game.
Did I do good that time?
You done well.
Thank you.
7-Eleven gas stop can be updated. Okay. Go take Stone Mine Tower. I'm gonna also auto resolve this because that's a very small battle too. Ruglash.
I've got some biggins. I wish I had some biggins. That sounds different. No. Careful.
Oh, nice. Finally destroyed the scabby eyes.
You did. I really should go get some terrors.
Good. Well, Matt Damon did a good job. He can get upgraded a little bit. Where's his skills?
Have some plastic surgery.
The dwarves could have mounts. Too bad they can't. Except for Thorgrim, who has a chair.
Yeah, it does kind of pale in comparison to some of the other mounts in this game.
People have like dragons, and they're like, the dwarves have a chair!
A mighty eagle, a chair.
And the chair.
The chair doesn't even move. It's the people underneath it.
Okay. Oops, I forgot to do an edict.
Oh
man, that border prince is going to town.
It is. Patch destroyed. Campiagn, yeah. Gods are angry. Great. Wonderful. Aren't they always? They don't exist, so it doesn't matter. Minus 3 obedience, plus 4 obedience, plus 20 growth. Kind of want your orcs to be obedient, so I'll do that. Okay, I'm gonna bring the orcs back over then, I think. I'm gonna bring the orcs back over towards my lands and take a little look at the dwarves.
Back this way? Oh, they yeah. Took Valea Sorrow.
I think they already had it. I think it's purely because Bithstone Mime is gonna be taken by the Border Princes, probably.
That's so stupid, because they're going to have land that's not connected.
No. Yeah, that's shit. I mean, I could keep going, I guess, and get the Dragonhorn Mines and Gronti Minigal. But the same kind of problem's going to be, it's not going to be connected. And
yeah, you should fight the dwarves. Dwarves.
The Ekrund, I mean, they have marble. But they have a massive garrison. And probably an army there.
Oh yeah, damn, that's huge. Well, I'll try and deal with that. That's gonna be a great, great time.
I'll leave that
with
to you.
Thorgrim and Matt Damon,
I mean,
will
sure,
take that.
If you're sure, if you want help, just ask. But if you're sure, I'm gonna leg it this way.
You go on ahead, good sir.
Okay. I shall. Oh, I still don't have enough of my blooming building. Is it worth? Yeah, because I want badass orcs. So I've got to wait for this building so that I can get them.
Thanks. Is it just the what was I going to say? Population or what that you're waiting on?
I'm now waiting on money.
Oh. Well, how much money do you need?
4,000.
Oh, I don't have that.
Nope. Nor do I. Surprisingly. I'm gaining like 400 a turn, so I'm just waiting.
Oh, yikes. That sucks. Well, it looks like I can make the Axe of Grimnir. This is some kind of long quest.
Okay.
So, at the start of your turn, have a treasury of 10,000 gold. That sounds easy.
No time, then. I'll come over and we'll have a formal procession for the orcs to inspect the axe tomorrow morning, shall we?
Yeah, 10,000. Like, yeah, right.
I mean, you're the dwarves. You must have tons of gold.
I have 10,000 ish.
Minus 9,000.
Minus 95,000.
Wow, so you're in debt of 85,000.
I think I can build a better gem mine, get some more gold. That'll be nice. Oh, I can't do anything. If the border princes will trade with me now that we're best buddies. This sucks. Cannot get any trade agreements.
I think we're just gonna have to resign to the fact that we're gonna have to try and be at war with the entire old world.
It's just, yeah, since I have a treaty with you, it just is ruining my reputation with every faction, I think.
Yeah, it's because we're just such different factions. If it was like the dwarves and the empire or something, or the orcs and the vampires, you might stand a better chance.
Right. All right.
Dear, approach me.
Oh, what do you want? Don't like what you say. Bloody dwarves.
Your guts tonight.
Your dear, approach me. Oh, it's gone. Oh, good. Another dwarven faction has declared war on me.
Why are they declaring war on you? They're not even near you.
I don't know. The other side of the border, princes.
So does that mean I have to fight them too?
I mean, you could. You don't have to.
How many mountains do they have?
Burn your mountain if you don't.
I literally don't have a choice when you call me into battle, so really? I have to help you.
I've got a feeling we've gone on the wrong campaign mode.
I think we did. In the beginning, I made it so it was co-op instead of just like open.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I think it's supposed to be
because. We have these like co-op objectives too, so that's probably why we can't break.
Yeah, we were meant to do the open one because then we could just offer alliance on turn one, and then we can break it at any time.
Is that something you can do?
On the other mode, I think.
Oh, I didn't think there were different modes.
I think there's co-op and versus.
Oh, whoops! Whoops! Well, we're stuck with each other for now.
We are. Doesn't that sound great? A great migration of the tribes comes to our borders, demanding shelter and wanting to join the fighting. Not normally a problem, but this don't smell right. I think there's English in there somewhere. Get out of here, gits. Plus 3 obedience, minus 10 growth. Alright. Migration, minus recruitment costs, minus obedience, plus growth. Obedience. We're not really fighting, so we need to keep them on side at the moment. Let's keep moving across. Can we use the underlays anywhere? Underlays? Underways? Not Mexican. Mexican underlays. Orcs. Watch. attitude. I don't know why I'm bothering. It's improving with the border princes. And it's apparently improving with the bloody spears, even though I'm at war with them. Everything else is deteriorating. Okay. I just have to wait. There's nothing else I can do. Not enough land. Hopefully I can go and take some of the dwarven settlements.
As the Chaosters, I don't really understand what that means.
The Chaos what?
Chaosters, like, are the Chaos tribes gonna start invading the Empire? Is that what that means?
Yeah, it kind of winds up, doesn't it, through the campaign.
So yeah, I think
normally about turn 50 we'll be on. 23. Shouldn't start yet. It's normally about turn 50 that there are murmurings before they're gathering their armies, and then.
Well, it might be amped up. Maybe. To start. Maybe. I don't know where I should go, because if this stupid border prince guy is going to take the town, I don't want to go help him. Bitterstone Mine. Oh, guess I went. Never mind.
Guess they've been in a big battle, maybe. I'm sure that army was bigger than that, wasn't it?
What happened to his army? Looks like it got annihilated.
Yeah. In which case, yeah.
Interesting.
Mine may be yours.
Well. Just need to build something. Alright. I don't know, these border princes suck. Oh man, there's a huge army right there. From Urkrund. In the underway.
Oh, it's the Red Hand, or whatever they're called.
He's got a bunch of goblins.
Okay, I've got it now. Chaos stirs. Storm clouds gather in the north. There are rumors that barbarous tribes residing in the shadow of the chaos have ceased striving against each other for the attention of the dark gods, and are instead banding together, suckling on the teat of chaos. The hordes grow in strength. It seems only a matter of time before the dam breaks and a tide of ruin bursts forth to engulf the old world, corrupting or destroying all in its path. You are all fucked.
I wish it said that.
It'd be great, wouldn't it? I'm sure you could mod it if you really wanted.
will all be effed.
Run away now. I think it's just starting the story, isn't it? Basically.
Yeah.
Right, where's my Valeria's Sorrow? It's probably the most likely, isn't it? They have a small army there. What's the garrison like? Pretty crap. Okay. That'll be our first target then. Are you at war with the Bloody Hand?
Yes. I'm at war with pretty much everybody.
Okay.
There's somebody who keeps getting war declared on them.
Well, why don't you break the alliance with whoever that idiot is?
The only person we're not at war with at this point is the Border Prince.
It's probably and the best.
And Zufbar to the north.
Oh no, Shady Mork's chosen army has low fightiness. What am I supposed to do about that? Quell animos. Fucking hell. Quell
animosity?
Let me take another run up at that. Quell animosity.
Numinous.
Animosity. Bash the mob's heads together in order to restore some fightiness to the army. This will cause casualties. Sure. Okay. I'm over to you.
Well, so oh my god.
I built nothing, fought nothing, and killed some of my own men. Good turn.
You could take your unit near totally not orcs and have them just go like raid or something to get extra gold.
Maybe. That'd be just being a pest though, wouldn't it?
Yeah. That's...
Yeah, I may do. Maybe use them to feel out what kind of armies Karakazul have in their homelands. She might put out one big army somewhere.
I don't... I take Bitterstone Mine, but then this big army he's got there.
Yeah, that's the thing. Whether they'll go straight back for it. I guess you're auto-resolving.
Yeah, it's not big enough. It's never big enough battle.
No. Gotta make it worth our time. You getting on top of your public order, you seem to be, don't you?
Yeah, it's... I think it's a lot better than what it used to be, and I've got all my edicts for that, too. So that is helpful. Okay. What is this? Oh, wait. Okay, so Karakazul wants to have a peace treaty with me.
Okay.
But they're at war with you.
I mean, you can do. They, if everything goes to plan, they're not going to exist pretty soon. So you may maybe try and get some money out of them for the peace treaty.
Oops. I didn't.
or just give him a free peace treaty, sure.
Damn it. Well, it doesn't matter, because I'll go and attack him anyway.
No, I need some land.
Well, I gotta get all these damn orcs near me.
True.
He's sending his huge army to go attack Stone Mine Tower, I think.
Okay. I mean, it's pretty straightforward. I don't know that we're likely to have another battle in this session, though. So maybe so. At least we've got a battle in each half.
Yeah. Yep. There's gonna be a battle with this. What's this guy's name?
Grunny
Vargas. Can't see his name.
Would it be a evenish fight if you did?
Might be, because I'm gonna have to use Thorgrim against him. But yeah, it'd be pretty.
Screw it,
close.
I wanna fight, okay?
And then I will spectate, because that's the only option.
Yeah, I might give you the Doom Divers or something so you can control the Doom Divers.
Oh my god, this is going to be the smallest battle.
They do have two on
Granny Red Axe. Huh? Oh.
It's only 10 units, but...
He's got a Grudge Thrower, though. You're going to have to deal with that.
True.
You also have a artillery unit, Redoom Diva.
I do. Okay.
Well, Jay, what is the plan here?
The plan is to have a main force, got some little spears in the middle to make it a bit more hardy, to make sure our middle stands up. Because I'm going to be splitting quite a lot of the forces off of the main force. As
okay.
Forces. So on the one side, we've got our Black Orcs and our Boa Boys. And on the other, we've got a big contingent of Orc Boys. And then, just on the side there, we're going to have the Doom Divers, which are going to be your responsibility.
Oh, snap. What about... Okay. Because you're going to have to deal with this other army, wherever it's coming from. It's like reinforcement army. How do I control this unit?
Insert. Press insert, yeah.
Oh, really hard to control.
You're controlling that one in the air now.
Yeah, like I don't... Oh, you're gonna make it!
Going?
Ah, damn.
He dead.
So close.
Yeah, I don't know where their reinforcements are coming from. I guess they're coming from somewhere.
Oh, oops. Didn't control that guy.
Went a little long.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot, you're right. That's way too long. Probably should help you out more than trying to manually do that.
That's right.
I think the Dude Diver is more or less good for getting the morale of the units than doing actual damage.
Yeah, I don't want one tiny little goblin's hardly a big missile, is it?
Huh? Ooh, right in the middle of that Dwarf Warrior unit.
Nice.
Oh.
Still can't spot their reinforcements. Everything's going.
Snap! Your left line there. Your orc boys are gonna run away.
Yes. Yeah, I did have a unit ready to go in the rear, but I completely forgot about them. Might just get there in time. I think they have. I sent a bit too many units off. Looking for the reinforcements, which I can't seem to find. So I'll start bringing them back now. Maybe they'll have army grouped together somehow. That definitely wasn't 10 units, was it? Actually, maybe it was.
Oh, I don't know. You didn't have any reinforcements, it didn't seem like.
Bringing everyone back to the center. the boar boys, we said, you just fired a fucking...
I can't stop it. Into...
Yes, you can.
I know, I already changed
They're just killing all my boar boys. Stop it.
It's not my fault. It's now they're shooting in the middle there.
It's completely your fault.
I'm helping.
Yeah, you keep telling yourself, I don't trust this alliance anymore. So yeah, we sent the boar boys off to take out the catapults, and now they're coming back and taking out the archers. I probably should have taken out the archers first, because they did way more damage than anything else. But what are you going to do?
Yeah, and a lot of morale damage.
So the only real problem now is Grunny Red Axe in the center.
Is he still alive?
He's almost full health, yeah. So we're going to send Grimgore over there to deal with him.
So.
I'm going to replace him in the middle with the Black Orcs. Left flank.
There's just like a bunch of Orc buddies around him.
There are. We've now got... I think we're gonna let them have a little showdown. Oh, victory.
Oh, you won. Fine. There you go.
Okay. Well, that
was a little battle. Decisive victory.
It was.
Probably thanks lost. To the Doom Diver catapults.
Well, we'll find out, shall we? Like, so the MVP. Wow. Okay, fair enough.
131 kills.
Fair enough. I guess they did their job. They actually were the MVP. Okay.
Oh, Red X got 53 just by himself.
He did. I left
and
him.
Thorgrim got Grimgore got 0.
I lost way too many men in that, but
just the spearmen. Look, you got new settlements. Woo!
Losing 500 as opposed to 8 when you're over 2-1 is pretty bad. We need money making stuff at the moment. Stolen from the enemy the crown of command. As warning countless battles, its wearer has great authority, instilling in his subjects an unbreakable courage. Grunny Red Axe was killed in battle. Wonderful. Oh my god, I have 4,000. I have 4,000 fortune. I can finally build things. The Goblin Tinkerer's Bench. Right, in which case we'll build some other stuff then. Now we've got some money from that. What do we need? More money, really. Pile of shiny stuff, that'll do. Right, I think we should leave that little session there.
Ready?
So, I have made the grand progress of a single settlement. I was aiding you in your greater goal, I'm sure.
Yes.
You seem to have expanded your borders quite considerably over there.
Three new settlements, I think. Yeah. Pretty big battle we had. So, a lot of action. Jam-packed action.
We did. Around some idiotic rambling and silly mistakes, but
sure.
I think we have quite a few settlements up for grabs names wise if anyone is remotely interested.
Mm-hmm. Yep, 3-4, just drop a comment and we'll put it in of a town name. Dalkaraz, Bitterstone Mine, Stone Mine Tower, and Varenka Hills are not named.
Indeed.
So 4.
Try and keep them at least PG-13. Would be good.
PG.
PG. It's in the game.
This game's for children, not adults.
Definitely. Oh, no, you have the blood pack on. It's 18 only now.
Oh. Yeah, it's... It's only $3.99 USD, I believe. Something stupid like that.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We all love that.
We do.
Not just one game, not just two, but three of them now in a row.
And they're all costly. Alright, cool. Well, hope everyone enjoyed, and definitely leave a comment on a cool town name. I would like to name one, if anyone gives a crap.
Yeah, just one, please. Even if it's something stupid like your mum, just whatever.
Yeah, I'll put that in there.
No, I'm not. That doesn't count as a suggestion. But yeah, I guess the only thing now is we seem confined to not be able to fight each other, so I guess our new goal, apart from the co-op objectives, is just to kill everybody.
That was always the goal.
I guess, yeah. Just not each other now.
Not each other.
Okay, sure. Well, if you're watching on mine, check out Forge's channel. Plenty of great strategy stuff, and you've started some game review stuff as well, haven't you?
Yep. So definitely check those out before you try it or buy it, or just, forget about that game. I only got two or three videos in there because they take a while to make, but enjoy that. And then if you're watching on mine, check out Jay's channel. He's got a cool co-ops going on, and some other newer games as well, especially No Man's Sky, that's brand spanking new. And everyone compares their games to that.
Yeah.
Every game is better than No Man's Sky.
Yep, it is. I don't know why I'm still playing, but I feel compelled to get my £40 worth out of that game.
Yeah.
Okay, well, until next time, we shall see you next time. That didn't really work.
See you next time. Oh.
Bye. Super Bye. Professional.
Lord Saruman's glittering towers in the morning light go overlook Edoras, the town that's going to be burnt to the ground, because I hate you, Rohan. Oh, crap. He sent his... Oh, no. I didn't even see that. Ooh, you sneaky son of a gun. He sent his spear or missile cav around the side there. That was sneaky. So there is a back way in.
Now, if you're gonna do this, you're gonna do it properly. Okay. Here's the third one. Third group. Right. A lot of honor being formed for their bloodied hero as he travels through. Troops standing to attention. Manfred giving them a rousing battle speech. Oops. He goes to some grave guards. They watch their mighty cavalry charging through after a triumphant battle. Although they probably don't have any emotions because they're mindless skeletons, but you know what I mean.